Did you know that not all hacking involves brute force attacks or sophisticated coding skills? Welcome to the world of social engineering, a fascinating aspect of ethical hacking. Imagine you're a security guard at a company. One day, a service technician comes in, claiming they're here for emergency system check. You don't have any record of it, but they seem genuine, have an ID card, even the company uniform. So you let them in. Hours later, you'll discover that the company's confidential data has been breached. But how? You had top-notch firewalls and intrusion detection systems in place. This is an example of social engineering. Social engineering is the art of manipulating people into revealing confidential information that can be used for fraudulent or malicious purposes. It exploits the most vulnerable part of any system, the human element. Now, you might wonder, what does this have to do with ethical hacking? In ethical hacking, social engineering is used to identify weak points in human interaction and educate employees. Ethical hackers impersonate attackers and attempt these techniques to expose vulnerabilities, not to exploit them, but to strengthen the organization's defenses. Let's talk about different types of social engineering attacks. Phishing. An attacker masquerading as a trusted entity tricks victims into opening email, instant message, or text message. The recipient is then tricked into clicking a malicious link, leading to the installation of malware, freezing the system as part of a ransomware attack, or revealing sensitive information. Pretexting. Here, an attacker creates a good pretext or a fabricated scenario that lures a victim into providing information. They may pose as a coworker, police officer, bank official, or anyone else with the right to know authority. Baiting. Baiting is like real-world Trojan horse. Attackers leave a malware-infected physical device, such as a USB flash drive, in a place sure to be found by potential victims. Curiosity and the promise of the free item tempts the victim into loading the device onto their computer, unleashing the malware. Tailgating. This happens when an unauthorized person follows an authorized person into a restricted area. Now that we understand social engineering tactics, let's discuss how you, as an individual or an organization, can protect yourself against these attacks. Education. The best defense against social engineering is awareness. Regularly conduct security training and awareness programs. Verify identity. Never provide insensitive information over the phone or through email. Always verify the identity of the person requesting access or information. Install security systems. Ensure robust security measures are in place, such as firewalls, intrusion detection systems, and email filters. Regularly update and backup data. Keep your systems and software updated and always backup your data regularly. Remember, the human factor is often the weakest link in the security chain. Ethical hacking helps to identify and reinforce these weak points, making the chain stronger and the organization safer. So stay vigilant and stay safe, because in the digital world, not everything is as it seems. Hope you enjoyed this video and check out this other recommended video for you.